Good evening. You're watching The Last Word. I'm Kavita Krishnan. Viewers, the story that we will discuss this evening is unpleasant, and what it points to is scary. Four young men in Alwar, Rajasthan, jumped in front of an oncoming train and they committed suicide. Now, their friend alleges that they did this because they were unemployed. The police are still investigating this case. But the death of these young men shifts the spotlight again onto an issue that we've discussed time and again on this channel: the lack of jobs in Rajasthan and across India. Tonight we ask, with state elections underway, with a general election on the horizon, and more importantly, with the class of 2019 readying to graduate in a little under 6 months, can our governments afford to run away from this issue anymore? Isn't it time they face up to the real problem and begin to address it? That's a question that we are asking of our panel today. And in fact, joining me on the debate tonight is a very illustrious panel. I'll take you across to them, but first let's take a quick look at this report.
Four young men from Alwar, Rajasthan jumped in front of a train and killed themselves. The reason, according to their friend, unemployment. While three men died on the spot, one of them, 22-year-old Abhishek, was grievously injured and was hospitalized. But he too succumbed to injuries on Friday.
वो ये बोल रहे थे कि जॉब अपने लगेगी नहीं, खेती बाड़ी अपन से होगी नहीं, और अपन से कोई काम होता नहीं है, पढ़ अपन नहीं सकते, क्या करेंगे जिंदगी में अपन, वैसे बोझ अपन धरती पे.
Meanwhile, the chief minister is busy campaigning ahead of the assembly elections.
How confident you are of the victory, ma'am?
I'm very confident of the victory. As you can see, the mood is very good. Mood is very good.
Ma'am, apart from that also, if we talk about the development rate, Congress has questioned that.
These are things that are easily proved because it's on the ground.
No, Chief Minister Raje, the mood of the state is not good. Mirror Now's own ground reports show educated young men and women are disappointed because they are not getting jobs. But government seems indifferent.
प्रदूषण सहित रहित फैक्ट्रियां यहां लगती तो निश्चित युवकों को रोजगार मिलता. यहां के ईंट भट्टे नहीं जाते तो यहां निरंतर लोगों को रोजगार मिलता. किसी ने रोजगार की दृष्टि से देखा नहीं.
ना कोई युवाओं की सोच रहा है, सभी बेरोजगार हैं, सभी काम धंधे बंद हैं. अब बताइए कि एमएलए यहां 15 साल से हैं, वो क्या किया उन्होंने यहां?
And the story we found plays out in state after state. Graduates armed with degrees are not getting jobs. So tonight we ask, what exactly is the government doing to fix the job crisis in India? Let's debate.
Before those four young men jumped to death in front of an oncoming train, they allegedly told their friend, we'll not get jobs. Hamari naukri lagni nahi hai. We cannot do farming. What will we do? Hum dharti par bojh hai. That is what these four young men had to say. And let me tell you, these four men were all in their 20s. And that's a question that we're asking to all our panelists today. Do we have an answer to men, to young men and young women like these? Young men and young women who've been told that if they study, if they get a good degree, they will get a job. Does the government have answers? Joining us is Rahul Singh, policy analyst, Vinayak Dalmia, spokesperson of the Congress, Santosh Mehrotra, professor of economics at the Center for Informal Sector and Labour Studies, Jawaharlal Nehru University, and Jitendra Srimali, who is a spokesperson with the BJP. I'll begin with Santosh Mehrotra. Santosh Mehrotra, you are a professor. You are constantly speaking to the youth. Does this story surprise you?
No, not at all, because the data based on the annual survey of the Ministry of Labour, which has a sample size larger than the National Sample Survey, shows precisely what does youth are saying. And in addition, the Center for the Monitoring of Indian Economy in more recent surveys post-2016 reinforced that. My own analysis from 2011-12 to 2015-16 tells me the following, that while before that for 7 or 8 years, before 11-12, the number of youth in agriculture was systematically falling. Between 11-12 and 16, the number of youth in agriculture has actually increased by a whopping 24 million. Earlier, the number of youth in agriculture was dropping because non-agricultural jobs were growing. After 11-12, all the way up till 16 and beyond that, as the Central Monitoring Economy is saying, the number of jobs in non-agriculture have not been growing anywhere close to the rate at which the number of entrants into the labor force is increasing. Please remember that between 2010 and about 2016-17, the number of all our youth have gotten secondary education, and an increasing share of that, of those who have done secondary education, are acquiring higher secondary education. And four of these youth were all high secondary plus educated. And what we've seen is that as more educated youth join the labor force, are looking for work, fewer are finding non-agricultural jobs. The educated unemployment rate has systematically increased between 11-12 and 16, and since then as well. So what the youth in Rajasthan, these four youth who are obviously from agricultural households, they are from rural, because otherwise why would they say hum kheti nahi kar sakte to hum karenge kya? So both those statements are borne out by the nation level sample survey on a nationwide representative basis.
Right. Rahul Singh, do you agree, like Santosh Mehrotra, that there is a problem over here? Do you agree with what the friend of these boys is actually telling us? That they jumped to death because they didn't have a job?
This is very sad. I mean, four youngsters are losing their life because of the job. Of course, it is a very sad news. And data shows that there are challenges, but please share me a country in the world which is not having this kind of unemployment issue at the moment, except some of those countries which are having aging as a population, where there are hardly young people, and those who are there, they are getting job, you know? So we are a country which was having population explosion in 90s, and we should have planned it through our policies that once these kids come in the market for the as a labor force, they are going to need a job. So of course it is a problem. Of course what Professor Mehrotra is saying is right, because this is data. You can't deny data. Issue is not that. Issue is you also need to read the sentences and the emotions which they have, you know, they have put in forward. Four kids, half an hour before on a station, chatting, laughing, and suddenly getting depressed and going before a train. One of them is 17-year-old boy. I don't want to make it political. Political activists are sitting here. They will take their positions. But what are you expecting in terms of employment from a first-year student? At least, 3 years of education has to be finished. So you're talking about high-skilled employment, and you are we are analyzing on data, which we are analyzing on a boy who died, unfortunately, who was just in first year. Two of them have land in their villages. They can go to farming. Their parents are saying, or relatives are saying, that we don't have any pressure. If they want to come here, please come. If they don't want to come, they should continue their preparation. So I'm sorry, I don't have enough data to conclude what Professor Mehrotra is saying, that actually there is a problem. There is a problem. We understand that unemployment has been an issue. We have debated that in this channel with some of the co-panels sitting here. But I don't find a reason that only unemployment was force for killing BA first-year student.
Right. Vinayak Dalmia, Do you agree there's a problem over here?
You know, firstly, I think we should all spare a thought for the family and loved one of the young men who are no more. And a completely, you know, unfortunate turn of events. But it does paint a larger picture. This is symptomatic of a larger picture, which is that in India and in Rajasthan in particular, unemployment and lack of opportunities is a big problem. In Rajasthan, you know, either you're going to be driven to such extreme measures, or you're going to try and find employment in neighboring states, because within Rajasthan, the opportunities are few and far. And it's unfortunate, you know, 2017, and this is data that is provided by your channel, in 2017, 13,000 candidates applied for 18 peon posts in the Rajasthan Assembly Secretariat. 13,000 people for 18 peon posts. And out of there were lawyers, there were CAs, there were engineers. That again tells a story. You know, when this government, the state government, came to power, it came under the narrative of a Suraj Sankalp Yatra, which meant a promise of progress, prosperity and development. And they had a golden opportunity because they had a landslide mandate and they also had power in the center. And therefore, there was no excuse left. There was on their BJP government in the center, BJP government in the state, and they could have done so much. 4.5 years is a very long time. They came and they promised 15 lakh jobs to Rajasthan. Where are those 15 lakh jobs? Under Skill India, only 30% have found employment in Rajasthan. You know, in the ITI skilling, 10 lakh people were supposed to be skilled. Only 22,000 have been skilled. I can keep going on. But the underlying story here is that the government which has failed its promises, a government which has failed its people, particularly the young, and now they have no answers. You know, and finding excuses elsewhere is not going to be sufficient. Unfortunately, it's too late. It's too late because the government's term is almost over, so they can't do anything about it. It's too late because the young men are not going to come back. And so we can just come here and debate. But I wish the government had done something 4 years ago that this scenario did not exist.
Right. In fact, Jitendra Srimali, we too agree that it is a little too late. But do you have any answers to that? Where are the 15 lakh jobs that the Raje government had promised when they were elected?
देखिए पहले तो मैं ये बताना चाहूँगा कि ये जो घटनाक्रम हुआ है चार बच्चों का, ये चार बच्चों में से एक की उम्र तो 17 वर्ष है, एक की 21 वर्ष है, 22 वर्ष है, और ये इनमें से एक व्यक्ति तो था जो लगातार फेल हुआ था और उसने जो जॉब के लिए अप्लाई किया उसमें उसके एक बार उसका सिलेक्शन नहीं हो पाया था, वो तैयारी कर रहा था, प्रतियोगी परीक्षा की तैयारी कर रहा था. इसलिए अपन ये बात अभी कह नहीं सकते हैं कि ये जो बच्चे हैं, क्योंकि इन्होंने जब इनकी ये सुसाइड किया उस सुसाइड से पहले इन्होंने अपनी फेसबुक के ऊपर एक पिक्चर डाली और पिक्चर के अंदर एक व्यक्ति जो है वो खड़ा होकर के सिगरेट पी रहा है और फिर उसने बात है मैं उसको मार दूंगा, मैं उसको जान से मार दूंगा, और फिर वो उसका वो जाकर के एक्सीडेंट कार से उसका एक्सीडेंट करता है. ये एक पिक्चर उन्होंने अपने फेसबुक के ऊपर और व्हाट्सएप के ऊपर और अपने सोशल मीडिया के ऊपर इसको अपलोड किया.
यानी अब क्योंकि इन्होंने जो आरोप लगाए, क्योंकि वो अब आपके लिए अनकंफर्टेबल हो रहा है, इसलिए आप उनके फेसबुक से, उनके फोन से, उनके व्हाट्सएप से ऐसी चीजें निकालोगे जिसे लेकर आप टिप्पणी करोगे.
ये उनकी जब ये उन्होंने जो सुसाइड किया उस सुसाइड से जस्ट पहले उन्होंने इसको अपलोड किया, उसको सोशल मीडिया पे डाला और सबको और अपनी सिस्टर से बात करी है, एक बच्चे ने, दूसरे ने अपने और पेरेंट्स से बात करी है. और वो जो ये सारा घटनाक्रम है अभी पुलिस के अंदर इसका FIR दर्ज हुई है और इसकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन चल रही है. और इन बच्चों का जो फैमिली बैकग्राउंड था वो फैमिली बैकग्राउंड थोड़ा कमज़ोर था, परंतु इनके खुद के जो पर्सनल खर्चे वगैरह जो थे, इनके खुद के जो हैबिट्स वगैरह जो थी, वो जो पुलिस इन्वेस्टिगेशन कर रही है और पुलिस इन्वेस्टिगेशन में जो बात आई है वह मैं आपको शेयर कर रहा हूँ. जो पुलिस इन्वेस्टिगेशन में आई कि इन बच्चों को और भी कई प्रकार के शौक थे. और जहाँ तक एम्प्लॉयमेंट की बात करें, जो इन्होंने जो अपने मित्र को कही है उसकी अगर अपन बात करें, तो मैं आपको ये बताना चाहूँगा कि राजस्थान के अंदर जितना काम 5 वर्ष के अंदर भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार में हुआ है, उतना काम विशेषकर युवाओं के लिए, रोजगार के लिए आज तक नहीं हुआ होगा. 15 लाख युवाओं को रोजगार के अवसर उपलब्ध कराए गए, उनमें से 2.25 लाख तो सीधी सीधी नौकरी लगाई है, सरकार की नौकरी लगी है। उसके अलावा बहुत सारी नौकरियां कांग्रेस के जो कई वो हमारे मित्र थे उन्होंने हाई कोर्ट के अंदर इसको इस पर स्टे लगा दिया, उसको रुकवा दी। इसलिए जो पूरी पिक्चर है ये इस पिक्चर को और इस घटनाक्रम को इसको अपन दोनों को जोड़ करके नहीं देख सकते हैं। देश के अंदर बेरोजगारी की समस्या है, यह बात सही है, और ये जो चार बच्चों की जो घटना हुई है ये बहुत ही दुखदायी विषय है, पर इन चारों व्यक्तियों की
शिवाली जी आपको ये मानना होगा, इनकी शिवाली जी आप इस बात को नजरअंदाज नहीं कर सकते कि सिर्फ देश नहीं राजस्थान में भी जो है बेरोजगारी की समस्या है। जो आप 3.5 लाख नौकरियों की बात करें, सरकारी नौकरी 3.5 लाख सरकारी नौकरी जो सरकार ने उपलब्ध कराए थे, आपको बता दे यहाँ पर कि 1,35,000 ऐसी नौकरियां हैं जो अभी तक प्रोसेस हो रही है, यानी जितनी नौकरियां आपने बनाई उसमें से आधी नौकरियां जो है उसमें से किसी को सैलरी अब तक मिली नहीं है। ये बात आपको आपको ये खुद आप ही के स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की डेटा है। और एक बात आपको बता देती हूँ, जो स्किल इंडिया की आप बात कर रहे हैं, राइट वन सेकंड आई विल कम टू यू, वन सेकंड, जो स्किल इंडिया की आप लोग बात कर रहे हो, जिस स्किल इंडिया की आप बात कर रहे हो, उस स्किल इंडिया में आपको बता दे कि कैग की रिपोर्ट है, कंट्रोलर ऑडिटर जनरल की रिपोर्ट है, जहां पर जो प्लेसमेंट फिगर्स है राजस्थान के स्किल एंड लाइवलीहुड डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन का, उस पर अब सवाल उठाए जा रहे हैं। उसमें साफ बताया है कि जहां पर सरकार ये कह रही कि हमने 42,000 से ज्यादा युवकों को नौकरियां दिलाई थी, सही मायने में करीबन 9,904 यानी करीब 10,000 युवकों को ही नौकरियां दिलाई गई थी, यानी आप 4 गुना ज्यादा बतला रहे थे नौकरियां।
देखिए, नौकरी वाला जो विषय था, आप नौकरी को और रोजगार के अवसर इन दोनों को हम एक नहीं कर सकते हैं। रोजगार के अवसर, और ये जो बात मैं कह रहा हूं, ये बैंकों के द्वारा जो युवाओं को जो रोजगार के लिए ऋण दिया गया है रोजगार के अवसरों के लिए, उस ऋण को कर अगर अपन रेशो निकालते हैं, उसका अगर अपना आंकड़ा देखते हैं, तो यह पता चलता है कि 15.5 लाख से ज्यादा युवाओं को रोजगार के अवसर उपलब्ध हुए हैं। यह भी साथ में देखना पड़ेगा। और बहुत सारी नियुक्तियां ऐसी है जो कि हाईकोर्ट के अंदर कानूनी प्रक्रिया के आधार के ऊपर उन्होंने वो लगा करके हाईकोर्ट में कहीं पर स्टे ले रखा है, कहीं पर कुछ। अभी जो लेटेस्ट जो 26,000 युवाओं को, शिक्षकों को नौकरी लगाने के लिए हाईकोर्ट से हमने किसी तरह से नौकरी लगाने के प्रोसेस चालू कर दिया। कांग्रेस के हमारे जो कई मित्र थे उन्होंने चुनाव आचार संहिता के आधार पे चुनाव आयोग को एप्लीकेशन दी और ये कहा कि साहब ये 26,000 शिक्षकों की जो नौकरी है उसको रोक दी जाए। तो ये जो मानसिकता है, अगर उन 26,000 शिक्षकों की नौकरी लग जाती दिवाली से पहले तो शायद उनके घर में भी दिवाली के दीपक जल जाते। पर हमारे जो कांग्रेस के मित्र हैं उनको यह पसंद नहीं था, क्योंकि उनको ऐसा लगा कि 26,000 लोगों की नौकरी जो लग रही है इसके कारण से सीधा सीधा कहीं बीजेपी को फायदा नहीं हो जाए, इसीलिए उन्होंने चुनाव आयोग को एप्लीकेशन दी और एप्लीकेशन देकर के उनको रोक लगाई। जो ये जो मानसिकता है वर्षों तक
जी, अलग बात है।
50 साल जो राज किया
जी, मैं अब दूसरे पैनलिस्ट को लेकर आना चाहती हूँ, लेकिन ये अलग बात है कि राजस्थान के जो टीचर है, जो टीचर वर्ग है, शिक्षक वर्ग है, वो भी सरकार से काफी गुस्साए हुए हैं। इनफैक्ट संतोष मेहरोत्रा, वुड यू लाइक टू कम इन एंड रिबट व्हाट मिस्टर श्रीमाली जस्ट बीन टेलिंग अस अबाउट जॉब क्रिएशन, स्पेशली व्हाट ही टोल्ड अस अबाउट हाउ द जॉब क्रिएशन इज डिफरेंट, जॉब्स आर डिफरेंट एंड जॉब क्रिएशन इज लिंक्ड टू द लोन्स दैट हैव बीन गिवन बाय द गवर्नमेंट।
Yes, of course, those looking for jobs is one thing, those who get a job is a different thing, and the difference between the two is called the unemployment rate. And what is interesting and important is that the unemployment rate has only increased, point one. Point two, that the higher the level of education of those who are getting educated, the higher their open unemployment rate. In other words, this mention is being made, oh, this was a 17-year-old, the other guys were 22-year-olds, this 17-year-old was not even educated. Well, the point is that the data is telling us that if that 17-year-old did get education, he wouldn't have got a job, because the unemployment rates actually tend to rise as your level of education rises. Huh? So, what I think all our panelists need to recognize is that young people have gotten educated to a much greater extent than was the case 10 years ago. So they are now looking for non-agricultural jobs. And that's what these young people were saying. We cannot be in agriculture. Their parents don't want to be in agriculture. Why would they want to be in agriculture? And the interesting thing is that the annual survey of the Labor Bureau tells us, on the basis of a national sample survey, which is larger than the national sample survey data, that the number of youth between 15 and 29 in agriculture has actually increased between 11-12 and 2017. That number, those who were in agriculture, the youth who were in agriculture, was actually systematically falling between 2004-05 and 11-12. Because the number of non-agricultural jobs was increasing, so people were leaving agriculture and entrants into the labor force were also finding non-agricultural jobs. Why should we be surprised that the job growth rate has fallen? It's fallen because the investment rate has fallen. The investment in infrastructure has fallen. Yes, it is true that mudra loans have been given, but mudra loans were given in 15-16, in 16-17, and in 15-16, the average size of mudra loan was 17,000. In 16-17, the average size of mudra loan was 47,000. For those amounts of money, you can buy a thela. You can sell some vegetable at best. And tomorrow, you may not even have enough working capital to buy enough vegetables to sell on the next day. So the bottom line is 17-18, there's been very little mudra money given. In any case, the point here is the number of entrants into the labor force is increasing. They are better educated, but the number of jobs are growing more slowly. No one is saying that the government did nothing. No one is saying that. No one can say that, because number of jobs would have increased. But why is then the open unemployment rate risen? The open unemployment rate rises, right, in a situation where more people are looking for work than jobs are available.
Right. And in fact, if I could also bring in Rahul Singh over here. Right. Right. I'll come to you. I'll come to you next, Vinayak Dalmia. But let me bring. Right, Vinayak Dalmia. Go on. Go ahead.
So, you know, we were talking about the mudra loans, and if you let this government continue with its narrative, they'll link mudra loans to pakoras. There's something that happened a few months ago. They started talking about pakoda walas, and they were very proud of talking about pakoda walas. So they link mudra loans to pakodas. I don't know if, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Please go on.
Can you hear me?
Yes, you're...
Okay, good. So they would link it to pakodas. That's the first thing. The second thing is, you know, this event is unfortunately not an event in isolation in Rajasthan. You look at the number of farmer protests. You look at the number of young people moving away from the state of Rajasthan. So this unfortunate event of four young men committing suicide is not an isolated event. It paints a larger picture. That's the second point. The third point is, you know, if my friend from the BJP is going to claim that Rajasthan mein pichle 4 saalon mein bahut kaam hua. Agar vaakei bahut kaam hua hota, to how is it true that the unemployment rate of the state is near 14%, twice the national average? Jo national average hai, wo ab 6.5 to 7% unemployment ki hai. Aur jo Rajasthan ki unemployment rate hai, wo almost 14% hai. Agar vaakei is sarkar ne itna kaam kiya hota, to unemployment rate itna bhayankar nahi hota aapka national average ke mukable. Dekhi, the problem is nobody says no government does nothing. That's not possible. But the question that we ask after 5 years of rule, both at the center and at the state, is, did the government do enough? Could the government have done more? And if so, what? And was it the government's either arrogance or indifference that they took the young of the state for granted? And that is the question that they have to ask. He'll come up with some policy that the government did. Of course, the government must have done some policy here and there. But that's not enough. You are not elected with a landslide majority just to do a little bit, just to throw breadcrumbs to the people. It is your responsibility to do work for the people and to go above and beyond your promises. You fall short of your promises. You have fallen short of the expectation of the people. You know, when Rajasthan, there was a Suraj Sankalp, and I say this again, a lot of objective observers in Rajasthan, people who are not aligned either to the BJP or the Congress, were really hopeful. They were really hopeful that, you know, this government is promising a lot.
Right.
But you ask them today, and they are either cynical,
right,
they are disenchanted,
right,
or they are just unhappy and disappointed.
Right. Let me bring in the voice of a citizen. We have Prakash on the phone line from Vijayawada. Prakash, go on. What do you have to contribute?
Yeah, good evening to everybody. I'm so happy for getting me to the debate. I have three things to share. Seeing the fact why Rajasthan is same, saying all is well and will come back to the government again. Number two, why they do not keep the promises in the manifesto when they know it pretty well, when they cannot do it or implement it. So impossible promises they do and make fun of the people. Third thing I want to do, say, recall things. They must recall her. And our friend, the BJP friend, is saying they have done anything good all the time. But they need to accept the facts and see that they can improve it. But the CM says we come back to the power again. And on what basis they go to the people and ask them to vote for them again? So we are really sorry for the BJP party. When they promise, they have to get back. One more thing will stop. They promise getting less every head in Indian, getting back the black money. And Modi...
Right, Prakash. Right. Thank you for calling us. We'll get answers to all of that from the representative, from the BJP representative. But first, let me go across to Rahul Singh. Rahul Singh, you mentioned earlier, you spoke about a population explosion, if I'm not mistaken, in the 1990s. Now that, if I'm not wrong, is what then led to the creation of what all of us in India at that point in time in the 2000s and in the decade, 2000-2010 decade, kept calling the demographic dividend. It was only when the governments completely failed to create enough jobs, that's when we started talking of a job crisis and the definition went back to population explosion. Isn't that what we're seeing playing out in the state of Rajasthan and across India today?
Of course, yes. I'm saying that, you know, population explosion was an issue what we were discussing in the 90s. But also, please remember that late 90s was the time when we were growing in our economy, which continued till 2009-10, till we faced the global crisis. The point I was making is it's not one term, one particular government, which is BJP or Congress, which is responsible suddenly for the job creation of the country, for unemployment of the country. What I'm saying is unemployment is an issue which cannot be covered in 2 to 3 years or 5 years period. It has to have a longer duration, longer planning. 10 to 15 years is the plan that usually undertakes to take any economy out of the unemployment issue, any economy making into progressive state, right? So the point I was trying to make, which Professor Marutra probably countered, I'm saying if young boys are going to take such decisions, job is, of course, is very important issue, but there could be another emotional factors. I'm not discounting, by the way, please do not take, political activists especially, please do not take a particular side of only job issue. I'm only saying that you have to cater to the issue of education, their performance, their lifestyle, and also job employment,
Right.
The demographic dividend issue that you raise, this is, positive when economy is growing and they are contributing. But this is negative, and that's how some of the issues are coming today. This is negative when it is not utilized properly. The data which is coming up today is true from CMI or the government. Everything is reflecting that there is unemployment increasing. But it's just not one state. Come on, there is a problem in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Himachal, Rajasthan, in every state almost we are having a problem. So I'm not at all discounting any of these issues. What I'm saying is just don't blast on unemployment and political rivalry and just kill the issue. We lost few people. Farmer suicide, student suicide should be the saddest critical point in our debate. I don't want to raise those issues. I only want to be more rational while addressing towards a solution. I don't want to be sympathetic, only to a particular thought process.
Right. Rahul Singh, in fact, I'll come back to you and ask you if enough has been done. As, you said it's a 15-year process. We agree that it is a long process, not something that can be done overnight or over 3 or 4 years. We'll come back to you with that question. But first, Srinivas is on the phone line from Belagavi. Srinivas?
Yeah, good evening. Hey, I am an industrialist and also I am a farmer. And let me tell you, there is no shortage of jobs in India, first of all. The root of the problem lies with the industry-ready students who come out of colleges for the industry. The problem is that in all the colleges, there is no industrial training, internship. Like in the hospitality industry, you will find little or no unemployment because they have a 5 months of internship, compulsory internship. The second thing is, whether we like it or not, English is a language which has to be compulsorily taught and they have to be efficient at it because today it is a global world. You have to know English. If you don't know English, I have seen boys who have passed MA and, they don't have English skills. They are just working as laborers. It is a fact. We have to...
Right. Srinivas, you brought up a very important issue and I'm sure Santosh Mehrotra wants to address it. Santosh Mehrotra, would you like to explain to him the difference between not having jobs and not being industry ready?
Well, on the issue of industry ready, your caller would like young people to get into internship. I would like to ask the question of your caller who is an industrialist. Does he offer internships in his industry to young people who are just graduating? Would he offer an internship or an apprenticeship? The fact of the matter is that our data tells us that only largest enterprises offer internships or apprenticeships. Small and medium enterprises do not offer any internships or apprenticeships. So how are young workers who are getting even vocational training going to get prepared for the labor market? Problem number one, industry must own up its own responsibility.
No, it's not true.
Second, government itself is offering, well, I'm sorry, I've been studying the skills problem for about 10 years. I wrote the 12th plan chapter on skill development and on employment, sir. Okay, so I'm currently chair of an expert group for the Ministry of Labor on the skills issue. So if you want to debate this, let's debate this. But let me come back to the government skill training programs. Unfortunately, too many of the government skill training programs are short-term training programs, and the PMKVY is one of their biggest programs. Unfortunately, despite thousands of people trained under PMKVY, as Kavita, you rightly pointed out, the CAG report has pointed out that their placement rate is extremely low. The government itself admits that the placement rate of PMKVY, the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, trainees who train only for 3 months, is barely 12%. Huh? So, and there is no apprenticeship or internship attached to that. So why isn't the government thinking seriously of ensuring that industry is brought on board to provide internships and apprenticeships? If that was happening, these young people who are being educated or trained in larger and larger numbers would acquire some job experience and they might be industry or job ready.
Right. Rahul Singh, I saw that you were disagreeing. Quickly, if you could make your point, and then I have another caller who wants to come in. Rahul Singh.
Sure. No, so I'm not denying the data. The only thing I'm objecting is that this cannot be the blanket statement. You know, the terminologies and the government and terminologies in the industry are very different. I'm also a professor, and I'm a business policy and economics professor. I understand and I see and how students are doing. Internship in industry and internship in any such format at SME level sometimes is not even counted by the government data. So what, you know, this caller was saying, I just wanted to support the view instead of rejecting it in a complete blanket manner. Point number one. Point number two, and I will repeat, data is right. Government data is right. What professor is saying is absolutely right. But the issue again here is there has to be a long-term plan. We create a debate on these kind of events.
Rahul Singh, very quickly, tell me yes or no. Does this government have a plan?
Professor Santosh Malhotra is in the government committees and he should...
Rahul Singh, we all agree over here there is a problem. Does the government have a plan? Do you see a plan on ground?
Of course not. That's what is my point. Last 20 years, tell me which government has a 20-year plan. You don't allow this to happen. Congress would say BJP has done everything wrong, and BJP might say Congress has done everything wrong. It's not a 3-year plan. It has 12. You know, 5-year plans are not the plans for creating a great economy or creating removing the unemployment. 1 5-year plan cannot address it. It has to. You know, think of Korea. It continued its plan for 30 years. Japan did it for 35 years.
Right.
You have to have a long-term plan.
Right. Santosh Malhotra, I can see that you want to come in, but let me bring in our government representatives as well over here. Jitendra Srimali, yahan par seedhe taur par keh rahe ki sarkar ke paas koi yojana nahi hai. Naukri banane ke liye, naukri badhane ke liye, sarkaron ke paas koi yojana nahi hai. Chahe wo kendra sarkar ho, chahe wo rajya sarkar ho.
देखिए, पहले तो मैं इस बात को कहना चाहूँगा कि बेरोजगारी की जो देश में समस्या है वो ऐसी समस्या नहीं है कि केवल 5 साल के अंदर, क्योंकि 50-60 साल तक कांग्रेस ने जिस प्रकार से इस देश में शासन किया और जिस प्रकार की शिक्षा हमारे देश में जिस प्रकार की थी, उस शिक्षा का जो कनेक्शन था वो जॉब से नहीं हुआ, और उसका परिणाम यह है कि आज इस देश के अंदर इतनी सारी बेरोजगारी का भयावह रूप हमको देखने को मिल रहा है. यह समस्या इतनी विकराल रूप धारण हो गई है कि इसकी समस्या का 5 साल के अंदर इसका निदान नहीं हो सकता है. और राजस्थान के अंदर इसीलिए हमने विकास को आधार बना करके ये ट्रेंड तोड़ने की कोशिश की है, जो पिछले 20 साल से ये चल रहा था कि 5 साल कांग्रेस, 5 साल बीजेपी, 5 साल कांग्रेस, 5 साल बीजेपी. इस ट्रेंड को तोड़ करके हमने यह कोशिश करी है कि हम विकास को आधार बना करके इस ट्रेंड को तोड़ करके लगातार सरकार को काम करने का मौका मिले, और इतना जो पिछड़ा राजस्थान था, उस पिछड़े राजस्थान को बहुत मुश्किल से जो विकास के पथ पर भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार लेके आई है, वह विकास के पथ पर पुनः भाजपा की सरकार बने तब यह सक्सेस हो सकता है. जब राजस्थान में सरकार कांग्रेस के द्वारा होकर के हमारे को जब प्राप्त हुआ था, सरकार प्राप्त सरकार में आए
तो
थे.
शिवाली जी, क्या आप ये कह रहे हैं कि राज्य की क्या आप ये कहना चाहते हैं कि इस समस्या का
और बीमारू प्रदेश की स्थिति में था?
जितेंद्र जी, क्या आप ये कहना चाह रहे हैं कि इस समस्या का समाधान यही है कि बीजेपी की सरकार फिर से बने राजस्थान में? क्या आपका कहना ये है? क्योंकि वादा आपने किया था 5 साल में नौकरी दिलाने का वादा आपने किया था.
कि बिल्कुल ठीक बात है, बिल्कुल ठीक बात है. जितना वादा किया था उससे अधिक इस सरकार में नौकरियां लगी है. यह आंकड़े हैं. और इसमें मैं बता दूं कि जो नौकरी की बात है, नौकरी की बात को और जो रोजगार के अवसर उपलब्ध कराने की बात है, इनको भी हमको अपना देखना पड़ेगा. पर
जी बोलिए. हाँ,
पर मैं ये कहना चाह रहा हूं कि इस सरकार में 15 लाख लोगों को रोजगार के अवसर उपलब्ध कराए गए, और जब राजस्थान में कांग्रेस सरकार से हमारी को सरकार को जब जनादेश मिला था, उस जनादेश के समय स्थिति यह थी कि राजस्थान बीमारू प्रदेश की श्रेणी में था. आज बहुत मुश्किल से राजस्थान विकासशील राज्य की श्रेणी में आया है. हम ये चाह रहे हैं कि यह समस्या जो 50 साल कांग्रेस ने राज करके इस देश को दी है, इस समस्या का निदान केवल 5 साल में नहीं होगा, इसके लिए सतत प्रयत्न की आवश्यकता है. आज जो बात कर रहे थे, बात बिल्कुल सही है कि जिस प्रकार के एजुकेशन आज हमारे पास है, उस एजुकेशन का कनेक्शन जॉब से नहीं है, उसका शिक्षा को जॉब से जब तक नहीं जोड़ा जाएगा तब तक इस समस्या का एकदम से निदान नहीं होगा। और यह बात सही है कि मोदी जी की सरकार में, मोदी जी की सरकार में भी युवाओं के लिए सर
जी श्रीमाली जी मैं ये कहना चाह रही हूँ यहाँ पर कि अगर ये ऐसी समस्या है जिसे सुलझाने के लिए आपको 15 साल लगते हैं, तो आपकी सरकार ने ये वादा क्यों किया कि 5 साल के अंदर हम नौकरी दिला देंगे, हम नौकरी बढ़ाएंगे? ये वादा आप ही के सरकार ने किया था, इसीलिए जो है ये सवाल अब आपके सरकार से पूछी जा रही है, चाहे वो राज्य सरकार हो चाहे वो केंद्र सरकार हो। नौकरी के वादे पर आपकी सरकार जो है बनी थी, इसीलिए ये सवाल आपसे पूछे जा रहे हैं। आती हूं आपके पास विनायक दाल में, आप कुछ कहना चाह रहे थे, यू ट्राइंग टू कम इन।
देखिए पहले तो एक बात बता दे दूं मैडम, नौकरी लगाने के नहीं, हमने जॉब रोजगार के अवसर उपलब्ध कराने की बात कही थी।
लेट मी कम इन सर, मुझे बोलने दीजिए।
राइट
मुझे बोलने दीजिए, धन्यवाद। So I find it
रोजगार के अवसर की बात कही गई है,
citizens of India,
रोजगार के अवसर की बात की गई है
जी, उनको बोलने दीजिए।
उसका भी आपको उसका भी बखूबी जवाब दूंगा, चिंता मत कीजिए उसका भी आपको जवाब दूंगा। यू नो अनफॉर्चुनेटली फॉर माई फ्रेंड फ्रॉम द बीजेपी, एक्चुअली हैव स्टडीड इकोनॉमिक्स एंड आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रॉमिसेज ऑफ जॉब एंड प्रॉमिसेज ऑफ जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज। इवन दैट इज हॉगवॉश एंड दैट इज ऑल्सो अ जुमला। Even if you, firstly, you lied to the people of Rajasthan, you said you're going to give them 15 lakh jobs. Now you're saying, oh, we need more than 5 years. That's a one convenient narrative. And then you're saying, no, but we never said we're going to give you 15 lakh jobs. We're saying we're going to give you opportunities of 15 lakh jobs. Even if you looked at the latter definition, which is also a falsehood, where were the 15 lakh job opportunities created? When the Prime Minister and his ministers are cornered, they say, do pakoda economics, start a pakoda stall. Even 15 lakh job opportunities were not created. Forget giving 15 lakh jobs. That's the first point. You know, you look at other data also, even Manrega data. Even in the Manrega data, the number of people captured by the Manrega net has gone down dramatically under your regime.
Job bhi, chote job, chote
name
job
one
bhi aap
policy,
nahi keh sakte hain,
name one hai. Intervention,
chote job bhi rozgar name ke one liye policy. Chahe chota kaam ho, chahe bada kaam ho.
See, okay. Vinayak Dalmia, frankly, I don't have too much time left on the debate. I get the point you're making, and in fact, I would like to get...
No, I'd love to answer this point.
Quickly. Make your point quickly then.
You know, it is an insult to the intelligence of the average Indian and an insult to the voter of India and to Rajasthan if they are saying all is well and before we came in, it was a Bimaru state and now we made it a healthy state. In a healthy state, farmers don't protest. Right. In a healthy state, women don't get raped and kidnapped. In a healthy state, 4 young men don't jump in
Jitendra
under a train track.
Jitendra Shimali.
You know, farmers.
Right. Vinayak Dalmia. Vinayak Dalmia. I need to.
Let me link it, please. Give me 5 seconds.
No. You've made your point, Vinayak Dalmia. Jitendra Shimali. आप रोजगार के अवसर और रोजगार के बीच में जो फर्क है उसके बारे में बता रहे थे, वो समझा रहे थे। फर्क क्या है मैं समझाती हूँ आपको। रोजगार और रोजगार के अवसर में फर्क ये है कि रोजगार है तो मेरे जेब में पैसे हैं। रोजगार के अवसर से ना मुझे पैसे मिलेगी ना मुझे रोटी। जितेंद्र श्रीमाली, क्या आप जवाब देना चाहेंगे उस बात को?
रोजगार के, बिल्कुल मैं इस बात का जवाब देना चाहूंगा। रोजगार और रोजगार, नौकरी अलग चीज है। नौकरी लगाना यानी सरकारी और प्राइवेट सेक्टर में नौकरी लगाना, यह एक अलग विषय है, यह एक विषय भी है। पर साथ में रोजगार के अवसर, यहाँ के युवाओं को कितने ऋण उपलब्ध किया, बैंकों के ऋण दुला करके उनको प्रशिक्षित किया, प्रशिक्षित करके रोजगार के लिए वो अपना खुद का रोजगार खोल सके। आप पकोड़े बेचने वाली जो बात कह रहे हैं, इसको कोई भी जॉब छोटा जॉब होना कोई गलत बात नहीं है, कोई अपराध नहीं है। छोटे लोग, छोटे जो है, छोटा व्यापार करने वाले वो व्यक्ति, वो भी कोई बुरे नहीं है। उनके लिए भी, उनको भी, चाहे वो कितना भी छोटा हो, वो रोजगार करता है तो वो श्रेष्ठ है। मैं ये कहना चाह रहा हूं कि रोजगार छोटा और बड़ा नहीं होता है, चाहे वह व्यक्ति कुछ भी काम कर रहा है, पर यदि सरकार के सहयोग के द्वारा उसको रोजगार मिला है और उसको रोजगार मिल करके और अपना वो व्यवसाय शुरू कर रहा है, तो इसकी जो अवसरों की उपलब्धि है वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार के अंदर हुई, और उन सब संख्याओं का अगर पूरे आंकड़े कि जो सरकारी नौकरियां लगी है उनको,
जितेंद्र श्रीमाली
प्राइवेट जॉब में लगे हैं उनको,
जितेंद्र श्रीमाली
15 लाख, जितेंद्र श्रीमाली
शब्दों की गुत्थी में तब हम उलझते हैं जब हमने हमारा काम पूरा नहीं किया है। आपके सरकार ने वादा किया था कि आप नौकरी दिलाएंगे, तब ना रोजगार की बात हुई थी, तब ना रोजगार के अवसर की बात हुई थी। वादा नौकरी का था, वो वादा अब तक निभाया नहीं गया है। एट द एंड आई वुड लाइक टू एंड इन अ लैंग्वेज आर नेताज अंडरस्टैंड, एंड दैट इज द लैंग्वेज ऑफ वोट्स। इन द लास्ट वन ईयर वीव सीन अ नंबर ऑफ प्रोटेस्ट, द जट्स, द मराठास, द गुजर्स, ऑल ऑफ देम have come out on the streets and protested. All of them had a common refrain, a demand for reservation in education and jobs. Now, all of them, mind you, are land-owning communities, one of whom has a significant presence in Rajasthan. Now, all of their incomes are dwindling. The farm income is dwindling. This is why they are looking for jobs. This is why they are demanding reservation. And they, dear Netas, are a sizable part of your vote bank. Next, you also have about 1.8 crore first-time voters who will exercise their mandate this election, whether it be the states or it be the general elections. Now, this is the same age group that is also looking for jobs. This is the same age group that will also graduate from colleges and universities. Now, do the math. This is the size of the problem that you are up against. These are the voters that you have to convince. These are the voters you had made promises to, and these are the voters that you now have to answer. We wish you all the best. Stay with us, we'll be back with some news.